T-shirt. I think that is a walk in the city. There's something going to happen in the city. Jesus is in the city. This year, let us participate because I saw ourselves there. And the T-shirt was white and yellow, the same T-shirt. I'm going to ask the evangelist to prepare the T-shirts. When the time comes, let's go for the walk. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the good news also, he has opened for us the door. You have any of us, we know this guy called
Bill Franklin. He's the only pastor that goes for the Lord. No one else wants to go there.
So God connected us with him. He's so excited that we are going to go with him there. He asked me, he said, nobody wants to go with me. Why do you want to go with me? And how do you think you will manage? I told him, if he can manage, I can manage. That word melted his heart, he got overwhelmed. He said to get me is very difficult. But, this is my card. Email me, call me. Come to Ottawa and I will go with you. Church, God is reviving the souls.
You know, for a long time, I wanted Pastor Latta to meet Bill Prankard. But because he goes up north to the Eskimos to minister, it was very hard to get him, and I didn't know how to get him. So I called Hunter Street. They said, oh, look up the internet. Well, that didn't help me any. Now, we had a breakfast from, who is it, from the rabbi that came. Yes. And I was, they seated Pastor Michael, say, on the left side of the hall, and they seated me on the right side of the hall, at the back, both of us. So I said, this is so silly. We went together. Why didn't they put us together? I was a little upset about that. Because sometimes I need help. Now, I look at the back where I'm sitting, no, I went too fast. So when I was there, I saw my pastor was sitting. So I asked one of the ushers, I said, you know, I'm sitting with Pastor Immaculate and I want to go and sit with her. I'm all alone in this at the stable, and they're all Korean people. They don't speak English. So I don't know if I can do that because all the seats are taken. Guess what? She comes back to me, we have a seat for you. So I go. I look at the back of me, and who do I see there? Bill Prankard.
I said, God, I can't believe this.
What a miracle working God thou art. So I went and I sat with him, and I said, Pastor Prankard, I said, I know you from the time you came to the airport church, and you touched me, and the anointing, you know, blah, blah, blah. So he said, wonderful. So I said, my pastor wants to come with you and I want you to meet her. He said, really? Because nobody wants to go with him. Because it's so cold there. Only the Eskimos can take the cold. So, I got them connected and he was so happy. The way the Lord arranged that. That's the point I want to make.
It's overwhelming. So I'm so happy that we're going to move up now. Is that not a blessing?
Amen.
You are our
you are our Father.
It blessed my soul so much. It's an old hymn. Church is not about a man or a woman. There's no Jew, there's no Gentile. We are one before God. He just wants us to come before Him with open hearts. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we are ready to go. I don't know what is your pain. God will touch you today.
Just follow.
are not our ways. His ways are very different. He wants us to know His ways. There's no any other way, it's only His way. He has a very good plan for us. His plans are not for evil. The challenge you're going through is not for bad. Amen. He has a good plan for you. Amen. He will rescue you. He will rescue you. Amen. Do not fear.
Amen.
God will rescue you. Amen. There's going to be restoration in what you're crying for.
Amen.
There will be restoration. Amen. He will restore you.
I receive it.
Because He's God. He's yes. God.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We can never compare God with any man.
Amen.
No way.
Never.
No.
He's God. Amen. His words are yes and amen. His words are fire. Amen. Even if the situation looks so hard, don't look at them with the eyes of flesh. Wait in the eyes of the Spirit.
Amen.
It will come to
amen.
Pass. God wants you to love all, even those who persecute you, even those who hate you. He wants you to forgive. Sometimes you forgive and the pain comes back, you go back to that corner.
Amen.
He said He called you for the nations.
Amen.
He called you for the nations.
Amen.
It's not about education. His body heavens with the saving strength of His right hand. some trust in chariots, some trust not, and some in horses. But we will remember the name of the Lord our God. They have bowed down and fallen, but we have risen. Stand upright. Say, Lord, may the King answer us when we call.
Amen.
When God gives us this scripture now, we need to know that the road we're in is not easy. When God tells you don't fear, that means there's something scary. When God tells you don't panic, that means there's something panicking your soul, your spirit, your mind. So when God is giving us this message, we need to know that there's something going on. It could be the spiritual realm you have never felt it in the physical, or it could be the physical realm you are going through. But He's preparing us and He's empowering us.
Amen.
So I want you to be prepared and encouraged and know He is doing something.
Amen.
Church, I want to tell you, you didn't come here because of me. You didn't come here because of anybody. You came here for the Lord.
Amen.
And that good Lord is going to bless you.
Amen.
He will defend you.
Amen.
According to the scriptures, He said, may the Lord answer you in the days of trouble. I don't know what you're going through. God surely will answer you.
Amen.
He will reveal His hand for you. Wait upon the Lord. I used to have that fear of credit. My credit was beyond credit. I could panic and cry when I go to pray. I used to say, God, how will I pay this? But God, who answers us in the time of trouble, paid it off.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He paid it off.
Amen.
That is God I'm talking about. I'm not talking about a dreamy God. He's real. And He says here, may the name of the God of Jacob defend you.
Amen.
Church, let me tell you, God defends.
Amen.
Let's keep our hands clean in every war.
Amen.
Amen.
I challenge you, keep your hands clean in every war.
Amen.
Even if people persecute you, forgive them. Let your hand be pure. Because God is going to defend you.
Amen.
When He's going to defend you, He doesn't want to find you on the way. He doesn't want to see you as an enemy. Don't be your own enemy. Let your enemies be your enemy.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will defend you.
Amen.
He will defend you.
Amen.
He will defend this ministry.
Amen.
So many things were not happening. When I was on the mountain, I cried, I said, God, don't make me ashamed for my enemies. He said, why? I have clearly said why. I said, because of the ministry. He said, it's not your ministry. It's not my ministry. It is His ministry.
Amen.
So He will defend His ministry.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will defend His ministry.
Amen.
We don't need to be worried. He will send provision. He will send workers. We need workers, and they are coming. You are one of them. Did you know you are a worker? Did you know tomorrow you're going to be a powerful evangelist? Did you know tomorrow you're going to be a powerful pastor? Hold on. Stand strong. You think you ran here because of a problem? He's going to defend you. He will turn that problem around. Because of what He has done, you will decide to serve Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because I never know how to serve God. I never know. That name Reverend was never for me. I used to think Reverend is for people, not for me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So He's God.
Amen.
He said He's going to defend you. He will defend us. What else did He say? He said, and give and strengthen you out of Zion. This is your Zion. This is the place God has set us. This is our mountain. When we come hot sun, where are we going? We're going on the mountain of new awakening of the church. That's our Zion. He fulfilled.
Amen.
He said, now I know that the Lord saves his anointed. Are we anointed?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Are we anointed?
Yes.
Yes, he will save his anointed. Don't waste your time with these witches. They are there. I'm not lying. They are there. Like the one we experience God real. Satan is real with this agenda.
Yep.
But we are not going to waste time on them because we are anointed.
Amen.
We are not anointed by devil's power. We are anointed by God's power.
Amen.
And the Bible says here,
amen,
now I know that the Lord says he's anointed. He will answer him from his holy heavens with the saving strength of his right hand.
Amen.
It might be so long. There's a friend of mine. They separated with her husband for 13 years.
Oh yeah, that's long.
The husband wanted divorce. I refused. I told her, don't give him divorce. If he wants divorce, let him take his divorce and go. But you are not divorcing him. Many times she wants to throw the ring. I said, no, we are not throwing this ring. And you are wearing it. When I see her without ring, I fight her. Guess what? When I'm in Israel, she texts me, this man is on my case. He wants me to forgive him. All those 13 years, God kept him bondage to work so hard for this lady. And God kept her bondage to intercede for his kingdom. Throughout this time, she was in intercession. Because I was on her case, I said, you are an intercessor. If he comes back, glory be to God. But you're not going anywhere. And I had one faith, he will come back. He will come back. I prayed for that marriage. Sometimes she would challenge me. But I have one belief. The God I know is God of restoration.
Amen.
I kept on asking her, do you really love him? She says yes. If you love him, let's keep everything in order. Let's do it. Now I told her, what do you want us to do? Should we do renewal of the marriage? She said, that's what is going to happen.
Amen.
13 years.
That's too long. Hey, that's too long.
Human beings will say that's too long.
That's
for God, 1 year is like.
And the human mind is too long.
Hallelujah. Patience. What is patience? It's
a food of the spirit.
Exactly. So when we have the spirit, we're going to have patience because we are naughty. This man will go up and down. He will go up and down. He will get this woman. He will get that woman. At the end of the day, he came back on his knees and told her, forgive me.
Hallelujah. I love
that. That is God.
I love that.
That is God.
Amen.
So, I don't know what is your request. He's still faithful.
Amen.
He's still faithful.
Amen.
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 The God you serve is faithful.
Amen.
And then what does he say here? Some trust in chariots and some trust in horses. But we will remember the name of our Lord.
Hallelujah.
Some trust in their relatives. I have my brother who's rich, I have my uncle who's this, I have my sister who's that. Others trust in their money. Others trust in their jobs. Others trust in their wisdom. But me and you will trust in the name of God.
Hallelujah.
I always tell God I have no wisdom of my own. I have nothing. All what I have is you. What you give me is what I need. That is our prayer, and it should be daily. When God knows we are depending totally on him, he becomes everything you need in life. You need a father, he's a father to the fatherless. You need a mother, he's a mother to the motherless.
Amen.
You need a sister, he's there. You need a brother, he is there. He will put everything in order for you. But who are you trusting? Chariots and horses? They will deceive you. They will deceive you. And he continued and said, but we will remember the name of our Lord, our God, the name of the Lord our God. They have gone down and fallen, but we have risen and stand up. Let me tell you, if you trust chariots and horses, you are doomed to failure. If you trust these names of people I'm not saying you don't trust them. Love them. Trust them the way you think, but let God be number one in your life.
Amen.
Before you consult men, consult God first. Let everything come from him. And when he knows that you do that, he will surely see you through. But if you don't do that, oh my goodness. Sometimes you say, let me call for this man who will help you. Oh my goodness. That man will only give you token. You don't give everything. If he gives you first, he will not give you the soap. You know me with my dark skin, I need good lotion.
Oh, quality.
If you trust a man for lotion, you are finished.
Amen.
They buy it twice, the third time, I don't have money. Learn to trust God. Even for the smallest thing, he will fulfill it. Even for your hair, trust God.
Oh, yeah.
For your nails, trust God.
Yeah.
We want to trust God for big things, but we don't want to trust God for the small things. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to tell God, I love my weight, but I want to be healthy. I'm trusting God for my health.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I strongly believe if I trust him to lose weight, by now I'll have lost weight.
Yep.
Because if we trust him for something, he does it.
Yeah.
I want you to trust God even with the little things.
Yeah.
He will prove himself to you, he's God. Because he's God. I'm telling you, when I say he's God, I get excited.
Amen.
Because I know he's God.
Yeah.
And he's here ever. The God I know answers prayer.
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes he delays, but I see him answering prayers.
Amen.
If he does not answer my prayer, that means it was my want, it was not my need.
Amen.
But he has been so faithful to our needs. He continued, what did he say here? The last one, he said, save all, may the king answer us when we call. When do we call? There are type of calls we do. You know, sometimes we call with laziness. I can call, oh, hi, sister. She's wondering if I call her. But there's some calling, I say, hurry! She will pay attention. How do you call her? Does it come deep from your heart, or it is just here? When we come to pray, what do we pray? Do we really mean what we pray? You know, sometimes we don't mean it. We are usually just saying, God, fire, God. You waste 4 hours. You sweat, you get tired, you fear. Some prayers never answered. But when you come with all the pain, you pour your heart, your inner being is groaning. That prayer will never go unanswered. He must answer that prayer. You are there, Lord, Lord. Hey. Again, you run. Check your scripture. We have Bible. He said he will active for us in this sanctuary. When you go to that prayer, minutes. You know when you go to that prayer, you never sleep. You know why we sleep in prayer? Because we don't need it. It's here. 2 minutes, 10 minutes, 1 hour, 3 hours. Church, he said, when we call him, he will answer. How are we calling him? Let's change the way of prayer. Change it. You are fasting, you say, God, I'm going to fast when it's 9 o'clock. Oh my gosh, you are thinking about McDonald's breakfast. How is that me talking?
Pull up. Pull up. Yeah, pool. The funny pool pop.
Bacon? Bacon, my love.
Oh. Mama.
You are fasting. You are mind is in the bacon. You left in the
fish. You know she describes it.
Finish it.
Really? You know she describes it.
Is that calling God? Is that business with God?
That was part of the pool.
You know, we need to know. We need to know who God is. He's real. And he deals with serious businesses. He doesn't deal with jokes. He doesn't take jokes. He's God. So I want us to change our prayer life. I want us to have reverence for the house of God. Church, we've lost reverence for the house of God. We are all over the place. You sit here, you jump here, you are laughing, you are chatting. Service is going on. Prayer is going on. We are all over the place. You don't even know whether you're in the house of God or you're in a disco. And this is the house of God. Let's have reverence for God and see the change. He's going to make change in us. When you come in the house of God, set your repent at home. I hate to hear when they say, the worship was not right. You are worse. you are worse than customer yourself. Because you are not coming for the worshippers. You are the one coming to worship. Prepare yourself home. When you are coming on the way, say, Lord, I want to go and fellowship with you today. Let this service be anointed. Prepare your soul. When you come here, if the worship is dry, because you're already anointed, you can even empower them. Hallelujah!
Amen.
Let's change our way of seeing things with God. We've learned so many ways in the book, not in the Bible, in the books what people wrote. I want to do it this way. I want to do it this way. It doesn't work. Because you're unique. God wants you to do it your way. What's your way? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ask God, how do you want me to do it? How? He will teach you your way.
Hallelujah.
Because you're unique. You're not me. You're not I. You are you. It's time God is going to raise up in a level we may not understand. But that will only come if we call him with sincere heart. With sincere what?
Heart.
We're not going to take the house of God for job. You're in prayer. Coffee is big here. Tea is big there. The bottle of water is here. You pray for 2 seconds and see. You pray. No! Reverence! Let's respect the house of God. This is the Holy of Holies. Somebody was telling me, no, the church is in our heart. Then where are we going to be? Hallelujah.
Amen.
And then why did he say we should never forsake the gathering of the brethren? He knew you would prepare a place for us to meet. And he knew he told Solomon.
Amen.
We are ready.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we are ready.
Amen.
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 So I want to encourage the pastors.
Amen.
It's not only discouragement, what you see, but there's going to be a big victory. Your prayers are going to be answered.
Amen.
Because you've gone and you are anointed. There's going to be change. There's going to be deliverance, revival, unity. He will bring reconciliation. He's going to reconcile families.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So we're going to pray before we take our offerings and tithes. And another thing I want to talk about tithes and offerings. The Lord reminded me again. When we bring tithes and offerings, let it not be as a command. Bring it as the appreciation. He has blessed you. He gave you that strength to go do what you've done. When you're bringing your tithe, don't grumble. If you have grumbled, then don't bring it. Because it doesn't make sense. When you're bringing it, bring it with joyful heart. He really wants us to be blessed. He's getting all our weaknesses to strengthen them so that he can bless us. I don't know how you've been giving your tithe. It's a command. There's so much teaching going on now that's old fashioned. Christ died, now no more giving tithes are offering. That's a lie. The God of yesterday is still the same yesterday. So don't be deceived with people trying to justify themselves with it. They pick one piece in the Bible and try to add it up. Pay your tithe. Pay your offering. Bring your offering in the house of God. And God will see you through financially.
Amen.
Financially, He really wants to lift us. There are people who have no jobs. God is going to bless you with jobs.
Amen.
He was telling me He has a heart for everyone to work. He will bless the works of your hands.
Amen.
He wants to bless the works of your hands.
Amen.
And that work, if you're not satisfied with your work, pray, call upon Him. He will change it.
Amen.
If you want your work, if there are situations at your work you want improvement, just tell Him. He will improve it. I'm telling you, Friday and Tuesday, I had a quality time with God. Quality time. I'm just remembering everything one by one. Whatever I remember, I'll say. But I want us to spend time with Him in prayer. Be faithful with your offerings and your time. If you have no job, He's going to bless you with a job. If you're not satisfied with your job, He will give you your heart desire. And the people who are challenged with immigration, He wants you to take a step of faith and test Him. He's going to reveal Himself. It's a very narrow road. If your heart is pure and faithful with Him, He will see you through. Hallelujah. Healings is children's bread. Don't worry about that sickness paining you. By His stripes we are all healed. Sister Lois was so weak, I was praying for her. I see this man, they are whipping him so strong. So strong. And he rebuked me so heavily. He said, "Look, what are you telling me? By His stripes she's healed." I just told Sister Lois, I said, "You know what, you gain the strength." I saw you were beating this man, that means healing has been taking place. It's something done already, you just step in it. So I don't know what is in your body, take step of faith. He will heal you. I want to pray for you to step up.